Oh my, such a wonderful place.
Yes, indeed. I must admit it's a dramatic scene. Looking at it is like a spur to my creative energy.
Akos, you think you'll write another play?
Perhaps. Gazing out at a vista like this, it's like a churning sea of possibilities. I mean, for example, a story of a woman who took to the skies on wings of freedom.
Sounds way interesting. I want to hear more. Akos, you must write that story. I can't bear it if you don't.
Abrona, it's easier said than done. Ideas need to crystallize a little first. But perhaps you could be my inspiration for this story.
Inspiration?
I mean, because you fly on wings of freedom. You're wild and untamable, and you've already got wings.
Oh, am I now?
Why don't you try flying a little for me now? Right here.
Yes, of course!
Flying? From here? I don't think you could fly.
Flying? From here? Wait, can you actually fly?
You're thinking of flying from here. I didn't even know you could fly.
What? You want to fly from here? You can fly? Way cool.
Huh? You really didn't know I could fly? So very silly.
Well, it's not as though she has real flight like a bird flapping its wings. It's more like floating around on the ether flow. Those wing-like organs let her manipulate it.
But unlike real flight, it's not affected by wind or weather. So I can go wherever I like. So they really are wings of freedom.
Hey, Abrona, here's an idea. Why don't you try taking to the skies with your driver?
With my driver? But drivers can't fly?
Can't you bear them up in your arms? The heroine in my story was going to soar the heavens with her loyal companion. That'd be incredibly dramatic, don't you think?
Now that you mention it, yes. If you want to take to the skies on Abrona Airways, just call me.
Nah.
I'm okay for now.
No, I don't think so.
I laugh in the face of danger, but no thanks.
What? No? You trembling mouth. I promise to try not to drop you. I'm not all that clumsy, you know.
Hey, wait a moment. That would be even more dramatic. The heroine drops her friend. Oh, the pathos. Yes, the muses have called out to me and I've heard.
So she will drop her friend?
That's right. Her companion will be dashed on the rocks below like a bag of wet rice. Now come on, Abrona. It's time you try taking your driver for a spin. Reach the highest peak, then let them go into the cloud sea below.
Okay, sounds like a great idea.
Hey, not so fast. I wouldn't want to fly without Dromark. There's no way you can hold up me and Furbagger.
Abrona, you better be joking.
Wait a moment. I just remembered something I have to do. Very urgent Imperial business.
Whoa there! Wouldn't you rather take Akos? I mean, you'd crap my style.
Come on, this isn't an offer that one can refuse. I'm writing the ultimate comedy here. Your help is appreciated.
No doubt about it. I can't miss out on the chance to be immortalized in one of your tales, Akos.
You're my kind of girl, Abrona. Living your own way.
It's true that you're quite the free spirit.
You're a free spirit, Abrona. I like that.
You don't let reality hold you back. I guess you're a free spirit like me.
Of course I am. I'm the very picture of freedom. Although, sometimes I wonder whether what I have is actually real freedom. I mean, a blade always shares the fate of their driver, right? Doesn't that mean we're kind of tied down by our drivers? You can hardly call that freedom.
Abrona, you surprise me.
What? How?
That's awfully insightful. It seems the genius of my story has inspired you in turn. I always thought that you were just fired by raw, unthinking desires and whimsical emotion.
Akos, you're skating on thin ice. I'm actually very thoughtful. Underneath. Like, say I've got some of my favorite favorite cantaloupe porridge here. Let's say Mia is about to eat it. My stomach says eat it, but my conscience says let my driver have it. Real freedom is being able to choose whether I sit back and let them eat it or ask them to let me have some. And that choice is up to me, Abrona. So in a way, I'm the driver of me. Being able to choose, that's real freedom.
Yes, you can make choices, and those choices lead to consequences. All of that is under your control. Although, I have to say I can't picture you making either of those choices. If I was to bet on it, I'd have said you'd have punched your driver and taken all the grub for yourself. Would you really consider any other option?
Realistically, that probably is what I'd decide to go for.
Hang on, doesn't that just mean you're being selfish?
But in the end, that just means you're being selfish.
But in the end, that simply means you're being selfish.
Hold it! Doesn't that just mean you're being selfish?
Well, choosing to be selfish is a kind of freedom, too. Not being tied down by anything. Living for myself. Not doing anything nasty and boring. Only doing fun things. That's the sort of life I want.
Yes, yes! You're the ideal inspiration for my free-spirited heroine. This is going to be the greatest comedy of all time.
Well, that settled it. I'll keep doing whatever I want. Otherwise, Akoth's story would be ruined.